Hey students, let's solve another problem on linear programming. Here, Avinash has been given two lists of problems from his mathematics teacher with some instructions to submit not more than 100 of them correctly solved for marks. The problems in the first list. Let me write the data. Here we have list 1 and list 2. The problems in the first list are worth 10 marks. Each problem is of 10 marks. And in the second list, each problem is of 5 marks. Okay, these are the marks for the problems. Okay, and then he knows from past experience that he requires on an average of 4 minutes to solve a problem of 10 marks. Here he will require 4 minutes to solve a problem of 10 marks, means it is from list 1, and 2 minutes from list 2 because it is of 5 marks. He has another subject to worry about. He cannot devote more than 4 hours to his mathematics assignment. With reference to manage his time in best possible way, how many problems from each list shall he do to maximize his marks? We have to maximize the marks scored by Mr. Avinash. So let us assume, let Avinash solves x and y number of problems from list 1 and list 2 respectively. Because we have to maximize the marks, so we will write to maximize z equal to, for each problem of list 1 he will be given 10 marks. That means for list 1 we have 10x marks because he is solving x problems, and then we will add 5y because from list 2 he is solving y number of problems and each problem is of 5 marks. So this is the marks. Then subject to constraints. Of course, the number of problems that he will solve won't be negative. So we will write this constraint. Then after we were given this information that he has to submit not more than 100 of them correctly solved for marks, means x plus y must be less than or equal to 100. He has a time limit of 4 hours, so therefore each problem from list 1 will take 4 minutes and from list 2 it will take 2 minutes. So therefore 4x plus 2y will be less than equal to 4 hours, means 4 into 60 minutes, that is 240 minutes. On simplifying this, we will get 2x plus y less than equal to 120. Now we shall plot the graph and proceed further. So now we shall plot the graph for these constraints. Okay, so here we have say y-axis, and then this is x-axis. This is y-axis, here we have origin. So for this constraint and for this constraint, we have to form the graph. So let's have a scale of 40 on each axis, 40, 140, 80, 120, and then again here 40, 80, and then 120 on y-axis. Okay, I will plot the lines with the help of green ink. Okay, so for this one, when x is 0, y will be 100, means here, and when y will be 0, x will be 100, means here. So this is the line. Which is 4x plus y equals 100. Now for the second one, when x is 0, y will be 120, and when y is 0, x will be 60. That means here. So let me plot this also. Okay. So this is the second constraint, so it is 2x plus y equals 120. Fine, once we take the testing point for this as 0, 0, you can see it is 0 less than equal to 100, means it is true. So the shading will be done towards testing point, that is 0, 0. For this also, if we take 0, 0 as testing points, it will be 0 less than equal to 120, means it is also true. So the shading will be done towards origin, that is testing point. So here will be the common feasible region for the given constraints. Let me erase the other portions which are not relevant here in fair work. Now we shall be taking the corner points. So let me call this point as point A, this point as point B, and this point as point C. In order to obtain the point B, we will solve this and this equations. So we will get once we subtract, means x will be 20, and if x is 20, y will be 80. Okay, and here x is 0 and y is 100, and for the point C, x is 60 and y is 0. Now we will make the table. So here we have corner points in one column, and then value of z, value of z. Fine. So now students, as you can see, the corner points are A, that is 0, 100. Then we have B, that is 20, 80, and then we have C, that is 60, 0, and we also have origin, that is 0, 0. So of course here it will be 0. When we check at 60, 0 for Z, 60 comma 0 means it will be 600, and then at 0 means it is 500, and this is 200, again it is 600, and let me mark it with red. You can see these two are the max values of Z. Now what to do, because we have two different corner points for the same value of Z, and those same values are actually maximum value of Z, and we have to maximize the optimization function Z. So be alert while I declare the answer here. We will say therefore Z equal to 600 is maximum at B 20,80 and C 60,0. Okay, which further means he can solve 20 and 80 problems from list 1 and list 2 respectively, or he can solve 60 and 0 problems from list 1 and list 2 respectively. But now comes the main thing that I need to discuss here with you. If you take any number of points on this portion of line segment BC, which I just turned red, means if you take any point on the line segment BC and put that point in Z, you will get 600 again. That means I will declare, in fact, Z will be 600 at each point on the line segment joining the points B and C. So that is end of this video. Thank you very much for watching. Please share this video with your friends, hit like and subscribe to the channel. Bye bye, take care.